Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about two important hormones of our body. These hormones are known as insulin and glucagon.
Endocrine part of the human pancreas consists of the islet of Langerhans, which secrete various hormones. Now there are two major hormones that are secreted from the islets of Langerhans. The hormones are named as insulin and glucagon. The insulin is secreted from the beta cells of the islet of Langerhans, whereas the glucagon is secreted from the alpha cells of the islet of Langerhans.
Now, insulin is the only hormone in our body that is anti-diabetic, which means it is the only hormone in our body which can reduce the amount of blood glucose level. All the other hormones in our body increases the blood glucose level. So, the glucagon also raises the blood glucose level. Now, the glucose level of our body varies in the various times of a same day. It is low during the morning and increases after a meal. The normal blood glucose level after an overnight fasting is 80 to 120 milligrams per deciliter. So, when the blood glucose level raises above the upper limit, that is 120 milligrams per deciliter, the condition is known as hyperglycemia, which simply means the raise of glucose level in the body. Similarly, when the glucose level decreases below the lower limit, it is known as hypoglycemia. So when the body is hyperglycemic, insulin is secreted and it helps to reduce the blood glucose level and bring it back to the normal condition. Similarly, glucagon acts when the body is hypoglycemic and it helps to increase the blood glucose level. Now coming to insulin. Insulin reduces the blood glucose level in a number of ways. The first process can be stated as glycolysis. In glycolysis, the glucose is converted to ATP, which provides energy to the body. And thus, by increasing the rate of glycolysis, insulin helps to reduce the blood glucose level. Now, another way insulin reduces the blood glucose level by promoting the storage of glucose. This process is termed as glycogenesis. Now, glycogenesis simply means the conversion of glucose into glycogen. This glycogen is stored in the muscle and liver cells. So, by promoting glycogenesis, insulin actually helps to reduce the blood glucose level. Insulin also promotes the transport of glucose from the blood into the cells by increasing the permeability of the cell membrane. Insulin also has some inhibitory actions on some processes which also helps to reduce the blood glucose level. For example, insulin inhibits glycogenolysis. Now, glycogenolysis simply means the breakdown of glycogen into glucose. So, when this process is prevented, the blood glucose level decreases. Again, insulin also prevents a process known as gluconeogenesis. Gluconeogenesis is a process in which glucose is formed from proteins. So, inhibition of gluconeogenesis by insulin also reduces the blood glucose level. So, these were the processes by which insulin decreases the blood glucose level and brings it back to a normal state in cases of hyperglycemia. So, now we'll be talking about the other hormone, which is glucagon. So, as we said earlier, glucose level is increased in the blood with the help of this hormone. Now, just like insulin, glucagon also has several processes by which it increases the level of blood glucose level. So, now the first process by which glucagon does so by glycogenolysis. As stated earlier, glycogenolysis means breaking down of glycogen to form glucose. So, when glycogen is broken down and glucose is formed, the blood glucose level automatically rises. And in this way, glucagon raises the blood glucose level through glycogenolysis. Then, the next process is known as gluconeogenesis. In gluconeogenesis, gluco means glucose, neo means new, angiogenesis means the formation of. So gluconeogenesis means the formation of glucose from amino acids. In gluconeogenesis, amino acids are converted to glucose. Now, the last function of glucagon is ketogenesis. Now, what happens in ketogenesis? In ketogenesis, the fatty acids are converted into ketone bodies. So, this was the final function of glucagon. So, in this way, insulin helps to reduce the blood glucose level, whereas glucagon increases it.